What do you guys know this omelet as?
Grandpa's omelet.
Just as the kids said, today I'm following a recipe known as Grandpa's omelet. For me, I knew it as one of my dad's Boy Scout recipes. All you'll need is a can of tuna, can of Vienna sausage, some sweet onion, a few eggs, and salt and pepper to taste. The first thing you're gonna do is drain and empty out one can of Vienna sausage into a bowl. Using a back of a fork, smash all of your sausages until they look a little something like this. The next thing we're gonna do is open up a can of tuna. Now I wanna know, do you guys open it like this or do you open it like this? Comment down below which way you use a can opener. Make sure to drain out all the liquid before adding the tuna into the bowl with the Vienna sausage. Smash it up with the Vienna sausage until it looks like this. The next ingredient we're gonna add is a little bit of sweet white onion. Dice up your onion into little pieces, and in the meantime, start heating up a pan with a little bit of oil. I wanna give our onions a head start with cooking, so I'm gonna go and fry it for a little bit until it's about halfway done. Once that is complete, go ahead and add your onions into your tuna and Vienna sausage mixture. Combine it well and set it off to the side. Now I'm gonna grab 3 medium eggs and we're gonna go and scramble them. Speaking of scrambled eggs, did you guys watch my recent recipe video where I shared with you how to make very silky, creamy, savory custard eggs? Now that one is worth checking out. I will leave that link to that video in my description box. Okay, back to today's recipe. Go ahead and add a little bit of salt and pepper to your scrambled eggs. Mix, 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 and then pour it into the rest of the ingredients. Mix all of your ingredients together and get your pan ready. Get it heated and add enough oil so that it coats the whole bottom pan. You want to make sure you put enough so that your omelet does not stick. I know you're probably thinking, ooh, that looks pretty interesting, but all I have to say is, hey, don't judge a book by its cover. This recipe tastes really good and you can't knock it until you try it. I allowed my omelet to cook on medium heat with the lid on for about 2 minutes. You want to check it until it develops a crust like you can see here. Using your spatula, run it all around to make sure it can separate from the pan. My dad has this flawless technique to flip his omelet using a plate, but I don't have a plate big enough, so I'm using the bottom of the pan cover. Once I slid it onto the lid, I flipped it back into the hot pan. And voila! And then all you want to do is cook it a little bit on the other side until it is fully cooked. Once it was complete, I transferred it onto a cutting board and cut it into pieces like a pizza pie and served it over hot rice, which is the way we like to enjoy it.
Thank you, Auntie Sally.
Well, before you guys take a bite, what do you guys know this omelet as?
Grandpa's omelet.
All right, take a taste and let me know if it tastes just like his. Does it?
Yes, it does.
Thank you, Auntie Sally.
Thank you, Grandpa, for the recipe.
We're gonna take this piece to him later, and we're gonna see if it's approved by the man himself.
Good job, Grandpa.
You're the best
omelet cooker ever.
Let's do it taste test.
Okay, so we just got to Grandpa's and we're gonna see if he approves.
Is it warm?
It's probably not warm anymore.
Does it taste like Mars?
Thumbs up. Did you guys think it tasted like Grandpa's?
Yes.
Yep.
Mm-hmm.
Perfect.
Okay, smile with Grandpa.